ولا تعتدوا. This is a very powerful command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not exceed the limits. Do not exceed the limits. Meaning the following. Transgression. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ولا تعتدوا. Do not transgress. Transgression indicated by the ayah includes mutilating the dead. We're not allowed to do that as Muslims. Theft from the captured goods. Killing women, children, and old people who do not participate in warfare. Killing priests and residents of houses of worship. Burning down trees and killing animals without real benefit.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. يسألونك عن الأهلة قل هي مواقيت للناس والحج وليس البر بأن تأتوا البيوت من ظهورها ولكن البر من اتقى وأتوا البيوت من أبوابها واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون وقاتلوا في سبيل الله الذين يقاتلونكم ولا تعتدوا إن الله لا يحب المعتدين وقتلوهم حيث ثقفتموهم وأخرجوهم من حيث أخرجوكم والفتنة أشد من القتل ولا تقاتلوهم عند المسجد الحرام حتى يقاتلوكم فيه فإن قاتلوكم فاقتلوهم كذلك جزاء الكافرين فإن انتهوا فإن الله غفور رحيم وقاتلوهم حتى لا تكون فتنة ويكون الدين لله فإن انتهوا فلا عدوان إلا على الظالمين الشهر الحرام بالشهر الحرام والحرمات قصاص فمن اعتدى عليكم فاعتدوا عليه بمثل ما اعتدى عليكم واتقوا الله واعلموا أن الله مع المتقين وأنفقوا في سبيل الله ولا تلقوا بأيديكم إلى التهلكة وأحسنوا إن الله يحب المحسنين
الحمد لله رب العالمين this morning inshallah ta'ala we will be continuing with our usual inshallah ta'ala and Fajr reflection and remember where we are at right now we are beginning from يسألونك عن الأهلة قل هي مواقيت للناس والحج وليس البر بأن تأتوا البيوت من ظهورها ولكن البر من اتقى and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in this ayah يسألونك عن الأهلة They ask you, O Prophet of Allah, about the phases of the moon, the changing phases of the moon. They are meant, tell them, they are means for people to determine time and pilgrimage. Righteousness is not in entering your houses from the back doors. Rather, righteousness is to be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So enter your homes through the proper doors and be mindful of Allah so you may be successful. MashaAllah, an amazing ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in this ayah, Ya Muhammad, they will ask you the following question. They will ask you about Anil Ahillah, the changing phases of the moon. As we know, when the moon is born, it's going to be like very thin and you can hardly see it. And then it gets bigger and bigger and then it gets smaller and smaller and smaller again. So people have asked about this. I said, Ya Rasulullah, what's this all about? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they are means for people to determine. This is the lunar calendar and how it works. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is also for Hajj purposes. Because as you know, Hajj is determined by the lunar calendar, not by the Gregorian calendar. So inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to bring to your attention something that Imam al-Razi rahimahullah ta'ala has said regarding this ayah. Imam al-Razi rahimahullah ta'ala has said, our ummah, the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ma kana قوم أقل سؤالا من أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم سألوا عن 14 حرفا فأجيبوا. So the great Imam al-Razi rahimahullah ta'ala has said, our ummah are the ummah who have asked their prophets the least number of questions. Our ummah, they were the ummah that asked the prophet or the messenger the least number of questions. In total, what was mentioned in the Quran, he said only 14 questions. يَسْأَلُونَكَ يَسْأَلُونَكَ. And he said the first one is وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي, the ayah we read yesterday. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي, when my people ask you about me, tell them, don't tell them, فَإِنِّي قَرِيب, I'm near. The next one is this ayah, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَهِلَّ. He said the total number are just 14. And those 14, 8 of them are in Surah Al-Baqarah. The other 6 are spread all over the Quran. And then he gave us examples of them. He said the first one was وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي. And then he said the next one is this ayah, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَهِلَّ. And he said the next 6 are in Surah Al-Baqarah. And we will see those other 6 questions. And then after that he said the next one that comes is the number 9 is يَسْأَلُونَكَ مَاذَا أُحِلَّ لَهُمْ. This is in Surah Al-Ma'idah. They will ask you what was made halal for them, what's halal for them. And then the 10th one he said is يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَنْفَالِ. They will ask you about the anfal, the ghanima, what is going to be done to it. And then the next one is in Surah Al-Isra. This is number 11. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ. They will ask you about the soul. And the next question he said that will be mentioned in the Quran is وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ. They will ask you about عَنِ ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ, who this guy was. And also they will ask you about وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْجِبَالِ, جبال. They will ask you about the mountains. And the last one is in Surah Al-Nazi'at, Surah Juz'amma. Which ayah is it? يَسْأَلُونَكَ Surah. Yeah. عتي أيان. الله أكبر ما شاء الله. That's the last question. ما شاء الله. Very nice, Ammar. Excellent. So this is what Imam al-Razi رحمه الله تعالى has said. Also, and the reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed this ayah, some of the ulama, they have mentioned the following. And they said, Hassan al-Basri رحمه الله تعالى said, كان أقوام من أهل الجاهلية إذا أراد أحدهم سفرا وخرج من بيته يريد سفره الذي خرج له ثم بدا له بعد خروجه أن يقيم ويدع سفره لم يدخل البيت من بابه. ولكن what Imam al-Hassan al-Basri, what did he say? In the past, during the time of the Prophet ﷺ and before that, if a man wanted to travel, he would leave. And if he changes his mind and he comes back and he doesn't travel, they didn't used to enter the house through the main entrance. They would enter their houses from the back door, or they would climb over the wall at the back of the house and enter from there as a form of superstition, okay? Or a bad omen or something, or a good omen, something like that. So this is what they used to do. The same thing, if they were in the state of ihram, they would do the same thing. So if they don't, if they go and they come back, they would come and climb over the house, okay, over the wall and enter the house from the back. So this is something that they used to do. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to them, وَلَيْسَ الْبِرُّ بِأَنْ تَأْتُوا الْبُيُوتَ مِنْ ظُهُورِهَا وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنِ اتَّقَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, righteousness is not in entering your houses from the back doors. Okay? وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنِ اتَّقَى. Righteousness is to be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is something that also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was addressing in this particular surah, in this particular ayah. وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنِ اتَّقَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, righteousness is about being mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam al-Sa'di rahimahu Allah ta'ala said, وَأَمَرَهُمْ أَنْ يَأْتُوا الْبُيُوتَ مِنْ أَبْوَابِهَا لِمَا فِيهِ مِنَ السُّهُولَةِ عَلَيْهِمْ الَّتِي هِيَ قَاعِدَةٌ مِنْ قَوَاعِدِ الشَّرْعِ وَيُسْتَفَادُ مِنْ إِشَارَةِ الْآيَةِ أَنَّهُ يَنْبَغِي فِي كُلِّ أَمْرٍ مِنَ الْأُمُورِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُ الْإِنسَانُ مِنَ الطَّرِيقِ السَّهْلِ الْقَرِيبِ الَّذِي قَدْ جَعَلَ لَهُ. Okay, Imam al-Razi, because of the time, Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he commanded them to enter houses through their doors because that is easier for them. And one of the aims of Sharia is to make things easier for people. From this verse, he said, Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, we learn that in every situation, one should approach the matter in the easiest manner that Allah has made the means of doing it. If you are dealing with any case, try to approach it from the easiest way. Don't make things very complicated. As human beings, sometimes we make things very complicated. Okay, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and Imam al-Sa'd rahimahullah ta'ala has said, whenever you approach a matter, approach it in the easiest manner that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the means of it, of doing it. So the one who wants to enjoin, to do amr bil ma'ruf, for example, what is good and forbid what is evil, should look at the character of a person and his situation. If you want to give da'wah right now, and you want to tell someone something good, look at their state, look at their situation, look at the state that they are in. So he said she should look at the character of a person and his situation and use gentleness. He said, use gentleness. And he said, by means of which his intended goal will be met, completely or partially. Both a student and a teacher should follow the easiest way of reaching the educational goals. That's what Imam Sa'd rahimahullah ta'ala said. The same applies to everyone who tries to do something. If he approaches it in the proper manner and persists in it, he will inevitably reach his goal with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After that, the next ayah comes. وَقَاتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنِ اتَّقَى وَأْتُوا الْبُيُوتَ مِنْ أَبْوَابِ. Righteousness is to be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Imam Razi rahimahullah ta'ala has said, أن الله subhanahu wa ta'ala أمر بالاستقامة في الآية المتقدمة بالتقوى. وأمر, and he said, طريق معرفة الله تعالى. فقال وأمر بالتقوى طريق طاعة الله. وهي عبارة عن ترك المحظورات وفعل الواجبات فالاستقامة علم والتقوى عمل. And then after that he said, ثم لما أمر في هذه الآية بأشد أقسام التقوى وأشقها على الأنفس وهو قتل أعداء الله. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded people to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he asked them the hardest task. And what's the hardest task? The hardest task is to fight for the sake of Allah and sacrifice your life. وَقَاتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Fight for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the hardest one. And Imam al-Razi rahimahullah ta'ala said, this is the hardest taklif. Something that you can be asked to do, which is to fight for the sake of Allah and sacrifice your life. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَاتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ. Fight in the cause of Allah only against those who wage war against you. Only against those who wage war against you, but do not exceed the limits. Subhanallah. Remember, this ayah was revealed in Medina. As soon as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to Medina, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed Surah Al-Baqarah. And among the ayat that was revealed at the beginning was this ayah. And at the beginning of the stage when the Prophet ﷺ was in Medina, fight in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only against those who wage war against you. That was the people of Quraysh, people of Mecca at that time. They were the ones who were waging war against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet ﷺ was told to fight against them. And also he was told the way the Muslims should engage their enemy. وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا. This is a very powerful and a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not exceed the limits. Do not exceed the limits. Meaning the following. And Imam al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullahu ta'ala has said the following. And Imam al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullahu ta'ala has said the following. That transgression. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا. Do not transgress. He said transgression indicated by the ayah includes mutilating the dead. We're not allowed to do that as Muslims. Theft from the captured goods, killing women, children, and old people who do not participate in warfare, killing priests and residents of houses of worship, burning down trees, subhanallah, and killing animals without real benefit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Muslims when they are engaging in war what they should do and what they should not do. Okay, you cannot kill old people, you cannot kill women, you cannot kill children, you cannot kill people who are in places of worship, you cannot cut down trees, you cannot... Look at the ethics, look at how the Prophet ﷺ and our religion, how beautiful this religion is. So as Muslims, even when you are fighting non-Muslims, these are the things that you have to follow, these rules of engagement. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said in the hadith, أغزو في سبيل الله, قاتلوا من كفر بالله, أغزو ولا تغلو. ولا تغلوا. Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, fight for the sake of Allah and fight those who disbelieve in Allah. Fight, but do not steal from the captured goods. Commit treachery, mutilate the dead, or kill a child or those who reside in houses of worship. This is the instruction that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to give whenever he sent a group of companions to fight the non-Muslims. So these are the instructions that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to give. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَاقْتُلُوهُمْ حَيْثُ ثَقِفْتُمُوهُمْ وَأَخْرِجُوهُمْ مِنْ حَيْثُ أَخْرَجُوكُمْ وَالْفِتْنَةُ أَشَدُّ مِنَ الْقَتْلِ. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, fight against them, okay, if they persecute you, until there is no more persecution, and your devotion will be Allah alone. If they stop persecuting you, let there be no hostility except against the aggressors. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, there will be a retaliation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, in the sacred month, which is Ash-Shahr al-Haram, we'll come to those ayat. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was reminding us, وَاقْتُلُوهُمْ حَيْثُ ثَقِفْتُمُوهُمْ وَأَخْرِجُوهُمْ مِنْ حَيْثُ أَخْرِجُوكُمْ. The companions were being told, a time is going to come when you have to fight the mushrikun in Mecca. And you might even fight them somewhere near the Kaaba. Okay, but do not fight them until they fight you near the Kaaba or in the Masjid al-Haram. فَإِنْ قَاتَلُوكُمْ فَاقْتُلُوهُمْ. That time, if they fight you around the Kaaba, you fight them back. فَإِنْ إِنْتَهُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُرُ. But if they repent and they come back, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving. So what is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying? If the kuffar make tawbah from fighting against the Muslims and they become Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all their sins. وَقَاتِلُهُمْ حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, fight them until there will be no fitnah. وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ لِلَّهِ. And the religion will be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if they repent and come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَلَا عُدْوَانَ إِلَّا عَلَى الظَّالِمِينَ. And then the last ayah that we're going to look at today, inshallah ta'ala, is أَشَّهْرُ الْحَرَامُ بِالشَّهْرِ الْحَرَامِ وَالْحُرُمَاتُ قِصَاصٌ فَمَنْ اَعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ فَاَعْتَدُوا عَلَيْهِ بِمِثْلِ مَا اَعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, there will be retaliation in a sacred month. Okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, there will be a retaliation in a sacred month for an offense in a sacred month. And all violations will bring about retaliation. So if anyone attacks you, retaliate in the same manner. But be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and know that Allah is with those mindful of Him. وَأَنْفِقُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Spend in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do not let your own hands throw you into destruction by withholding, and do good, for Allah certainly loves the good doers. إن الله يحب المحسنين. As you can see, these ayat, the companions were being commanded to defend themselves, to fight against their enemy, but also do not exceed the limits where they don't kill old people, they don't kill women, they don't kill children, they don't burn down trees, for example, they don't cut down trees. And all of these things, those people who are worshipping, who are in places of worship, they should not kill them as well, and so forth. So these are, alhamdulillah, the rules of engagement if there is a fight or a war between the Muslims and the non-Muslims. So right now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has reminded the Muslims, this is what is going to happen. And these ayat were revealed before the battle of Badr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was telling the companions, a time is going to come when this is going to happen. And also, what else was happening, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was being told, and his companions were being told, if somebody transgresses against you, you can transgress against them as well, according to what they have done to you, okay? But do not exceed and go overboard. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَمَنْ اَعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ فَاعْتَدُوا عَلَيْهِ بِمِثْلِ مَا اَعْتَدَى عَلَيْهِ. If anyone attacks you, retaliate in the same manner, but don't overdo it, okay? Don't do something more than... Do not do something to them which they have not done to you. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded the believers in this surah. So inshallah ta'ala, tomorrow we will be starting from another important ruling, which is going to be the rulings regarding al-hajj. And inshallah ta'ala, this is where we're going to stop for today's Fajr reflection. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.